what did you get by annotating? Did you get anything by annotating? Tell me. Okay. Now waiting room is enabled, as disabled, and annotation is off. So we were doing
now page number 24.
Yes, we will start page number 24. Yes. Who will read?
Ma'am Satvik.
Okay, Satvik, start. Ayush, Ratan raised hand. Satvik and student. Five students raised hand, but I am not able to. Aha. Okay, but you are not able to see the screen now.
Have skinned the likeness of a boy in first standard and made him smear the blood on his face. No one had actually seen it, but year after, the story persisted among the boys. Swami's head was dizzy with confusion, intrinsic to Samuel's character. Whether he was good or bad, whether he deserved the allegiance in the letter or not, Swami felt an impulse to run home and beg his father to take back letter. But the father was an obstinate man. As he approached the yellow building, he realized that he was perjuring himself and was running his teacher. Probably the headmaster would dismiss Samuel and then the police would chain him and put him in jail. For all this disgrace, humiliation and suffering, who could be responsible? Swami stuttered. The more he doubted of Samuel, the more he grieved for him. The dark face, his small red streaked eyes, his thin line of mustache, his seven cheek and chin, his yellow coat, everything filled Swami with sorrow as he felt the bulk of the letter in his pocket. He felt like an executioner. For a moment, he was angry with his father and wondered why he should not fly into the gutter. The letter of a man so unresponsible and
background noise is coming.
As he entered the school gate, an idea occurred to him. As he entered the school gate, an idea occurred to him. A short
class.
As he entered the school gate, an idea of
Satvik, unmute yourself and continue reading.
Yes, ma'am. As he entered the school gate, an idea occurred to him, a sort of solution. He would not deliver the letter to the headmaster immediately, but at the end of the day, to that extent, he would disobey his father and exercise his independence. There was nothing wrong in it, and father would not know it anyway. If the letter was given at the end of the day, there was a chance that Samuel might do something to justify the letter.
Huh. Okay, Satvik. So, what happened? Swami tried to get rid of his school on Monday, but it became very difficult. He put himself into a great problem. Father wrote a letter against Samuel, and he was supposed to go with the letter. Now, Swami was very much confused about Samuel's character. Whatever he remembered about Samuel, all was very good. He found him very genial. Genial means friendly. And whatever he had heard from others, it proved that Shyamal was a very violent teacher. Now, father wrote the letter and he was very much confused. Whether he was thinking that if he would deliver the letter to the headmaster would dismiss him from the job and he would be sent to jail. And Swami considered himself to be the worst perjurer on earth because he had done all these things. He had complained to his father. So he didn't want to deliver the letter. He was considering himself as a hangman. He was very much angry with his father. And he wanted to throw the letter into the gutter. Mind it, he didn't throw the letter. He wanted to throw the letter into the gutter. As he entered the school gate, one idea came into his mind. What was the idea? The idea was that he would deliver the letter at the end of the day. And in this way, he would get the whole day to justify his father's letter. If Samuel is a violent teacher, he would be beating him. And in this way, he would be getting proof. Okay, till here, any problem is there? Anyone unmute yourself and tell me? Nine student raised hand. Okay. Ayush Ratan. First Ayush yes. Ratan will read, then Aprajita will read, that then Shruti Mishra will read. After that, we will discuss. Okay. First Ayush Ratan, Swam. Aprajita, Shruti Mishra. Okay.
Start, Swami stood Swami stood at the entrance to his class. Samuel was teaching arithmetic. He looked at Swami for a moment. Swami stood hoping that Samuel would fall on him and tear his skin off. But Samuel merely asked, "Are you just coming to the class?" "Yes, sir. You are half an hour late. I know it." Swami hoped that he would be attacked now. He almost prayed, "God of Tirupati, please make Samuel beat me." "Why are you late?" Swami wanted to reply, "Just to see what you can do." But the Murli said, "I have a headache, sir." "Then why did you come to the school at all?" The most unexpected question from Samuel. "My father said that I shouldn't miss the class, sir," said Swami. This seemed to impress Samuel. "Your father is quite right. A very sensible man. We want more parents like him."
So, what happened now? Swami stood at the entrance to his class. Samuel was teaching arithmetic. Samuel looked at Swami for a moment and he hoped that Samuel would fall on him and tear his skin off. He was thinking that now he is going to beat him severely and he would be getting the proof. But what did Samuel say? "Are you just coming to the class?" Swami answered, "Yes. Yes, sir. You're half an hour late. I know it." Swami hoped that he would be attacked now. And he almost prayed, "God of Tirupati, please make Samuel beat me." Have you heard about any student who wished, who prayed to God for being beaten? Aisa hota hai kya?
No, ma'am.
But he was praying. Why are you late? Just Samuel simply asked a simple question. Why are you late? Swami wanted to reply just to see what you can do. Man to uski ichha to ho rahi thi ki wo bole ki bas dekhna tha ki aap kya karte hain. But he didn't say so. He said that I have a headache, sir. Then why did you come to this school at all? Now Samuel became very much concerned about his health. He said that when you had headache, you should not have come to school. The most unexpected question from Samuel. My father said that I should not miss the class, sir, said Swami. Swami was thinking that he would be beaten by the teacher, but teacher is getting very much concerned about his health. Teacher was getting very much concerned. Then what did Swami say? He said that my father didn't allow me to miss the, said that I should not miss the class. Samuel became very much impressed with his father, his father's sensibility. He told, yes, your father is quite right, a very sensible man. We want more parents like him. He was telling that he wanted more parents like him. Now Swami is thinking, oh dear, you don't know what my father has done to you. He was more puzzled than ever about Samuel's characters. Now Swami was very much puzzled about Samuel's character. What type of man he is? All the stories about him was proving him to be a very cruel man, cruel teacher, but his behavior was quite opposite. Huh, next, whose turn? I said?
Aparajita, Meera.
Huh, Aparajita, start.
All right, go to your seat. Have you still a headache? Slightly, sir. Swami went to his seat with a bleeding heart. He had never met a man so good as Samuel. The teacher was inspecting in the home lessons. Produced at least great violence. Notebooks would be flung at faces. Boys would be abused, canned and made to stand up on benches. But today, Samuel appeared to have developed more tolerance and gentleness, pushed away the bad books, just touched people with the cane. Never made anyone stand up for more than a few minutes. Swami turn came. He almost thanked God for the chance. Swaminathan, where is your homework? I have not done any homework, sir, he said blandly. There was a pause. Why? Headache? Asked Samuel. Yes, sir. All right, sit down. Swami sat down, wondering what had come over Samuel. The period came to an end and Swami felt desolate. The last period for the day was again taken. Samuel. He came this time to teach them Indian history. The period began at 3:45 and ended 4:30. Swaminathan had sat through the previous periods thinking acutely. He could not devise any means of provoking Samuel. When the clock struck 4, Swami felt
desperate.
Half an hour more, Samuel was reading the Vasco da Gama's arrival in India. The boy listened in half languor. Swami suddenly asked at the top of his voice, why did not Columbus cease come to India, sir?
Huh, okay, Aparajita. Yes. Okay, now let me explain. So, when it was homework's turn, he was feeling that he would be getting a chance to get beaten, but this also didn't happen. When he blandly, what is the meaning of blandly? He blandly told that he had not done any homework.
Ma'am, gently.
He simply said that I have not done any homework. Samuel asked, why headache? Samuel himself asked, oh, you could not do your homework because of headache. Now, all right, Samuel said, all right, sit down. Swami was wondering, what had come over Samuel? Samuel ko hua kya hai? Aaj to kisi ko peet bhi nahi rahe hain. Jyada der khade bhi nahi kar rahe hain. So, Swami felt desolate. Desolate means miserable. His condition was pitiable. He wanted Samuel to be because he had to justify his father's
letter. Ma'am, miserable.
Miserable. So, he wanted Samuel to become angry and weak so that he could justify his father's letter. But this was not happen. This didn't happen in first period. Last period was also there. And Samuel was supposed to teach history, Indian history in that period. First period, he came to teach arithmetic. And in last period, he was supposed to teach Indian history. The period began at 3:45 and ended at 4:30. Swami had sat through the previous period thinking acutely. He could not devise any means of provoking Samuel. Now he was thinking and thinking how to provoke Samuel. Kis tarike se Samuel ko gussa dilana hai. He was thinking about that. But he didn't get any men. When the clock struck 4, Swami felt disparate. Ab jab 4 o'clock, it was 4 o'clock time, only half an hour was left. He was very much puzzled how to provoke Samuel. Samuel was reading the red text, the portion describing Vasco da Gama's arrival in India. What was being taught? Vasco da Gama's arrival in India. The boy listened in half language. Half language means with a dull mind.
Then Vasco da Gama's first count of Vidi Gaudia was a Portuguese explorer and first European to reach India by sea.
Good Hope, na? Kya tha? Cape of route. What was his route? Cape of Good Hope. So in a half language means with a dull mind. When it is last period, students
with a dull mind.
Last period, जब तुम लोगों के भी class में होता है, तो थोड़ा सा dull feel करते हो ना? Feel tired, last period उतना पढ़ने का मन नहीं होता है, थोड़ी सी शैतानी भी कर लेते हो. It is like that?
Yes, ma'am.
First period जितना energetic feel होता है, last period is not like that. So, students were the same there also, and they were listening to with a dull mind. Active participation उतना नहीं था उन लोगों का. Swami suddenly asked at the top of his voice. सारे बच्चे शांति से सुन रहे थे. Swami shouted. What did he shout? Why didn't Columbus come to India, sir? चलो अब इसका श्रुति मिश्रा विल रीड ना.
I'm Kenai Anushan.
No, actually I had given turn to Shruti Mishra. Is it it?
After it, can I Anushka?
I start.
I thought it is unbelievable, sir. Why such a great man would he have not know the way? Don't shout. I can hear you quite well. I am not shouting, sir. This is my ordinary voice which God has given me. How can I help you? Shut up and sit down. Swaminathan sat down feeling slightly happy at his success. The teacher threw a puzzled, suspicious glance at him and resumed his lesson. His next chance occurred when Shankar of the first bench got up and asked, sir, was Vasco da Gama the very first person to come to India? Before the teacher could answer, Swami shouted from the back bench, that's what they say. The teacher and all the boys looked at Swami. The teacher was puzzled by Swami's obtrusive behavior today. Nathan, you are shouting again. I am not shouting, sir. How can I help my voice given by God? The school clock struck a quarter more. Swami said something drastic in 15 minutes. Samuel had no doubt scolded at him and snubbed him, but it was hardly adequate. Swami felt that with a little more effort, Samuel could be made to deserve dismissal and imprisonment. The teacher came to the end of a section in the textbook and stopped. He proposed to spend the remaining few minutes putting questions to the board. He ordered the whole class to put away their books and asked someone in the second row, "What is the date of Vasco da Gama's arrival in India?"
Why didn't Columbus come to India, sir? This was his question. Samuel simply asked, he lost his way. Now he started shouting. "I can't believe it. It is unbelievable." Samuel asked, "Why?" "Such a great man. Would he have not known the way?" "Don't shout. I can hear you quite well." "I'm not shouting, sir. This is my ordinary voice, which God has given me. How can I help it?" So now he was shouting, and Samuel was trying to answer very peacefully. But now he was getting a little bit irritated. So he told that, "No, I don't believe that such a great man would lose the way, will not remember the way." Samuel said not to shout. And he simply said that he was not shouting. He was just speaking with the voice given by the God. Now Samuel got irritated and said, shut up and sit down. Swaminathan sat down, but he was feeling happy, slightly happy, because he was able to irritate the teacher. And Samuel was very much puzzled. He was thinking, what had happened to the student? What had happened to Swami? His next chance occurred when Shankar of the first bench got up and asked, "Sir, was Vasco da Gama was the first, very first person to come to India?" Shankar asked another question to Samuel. Before teacher could say anything, Swami shouted, "That's what they say." The teacher and all the boys looked at Swami. All the students started looking at Swami. The teacher was very puzzled by Swami's obtrusive behavior today. What is the meaning of obtrusive behavior? Will anyone
difficult to understand? Difficult to understand.
Yes. Because Swami was
difficult to understand.
Swami was not like that. It was his unusual behavior. "Swami Nathan, you are shouting again." "I'm not shouting, sir. How can I help my voice given by the God? Given by God. The school clock struck a quarter four." A quarter more. Swami felt he must do something drastic in 15 minutes. Now, Swami was able to irritate the teacher, but still, that was not enough to deliver the letter. He wanted to do something drastic, means something very annoying, so that Samuel could beat him. Swami felt that a little more effort, Samuel could be made to deserve dismissal and imprisonment. Now he was thinking, "Thodi si mehnat aur karni hai, aur father's letter would be justified." The teacher came to the end of the section in the textbook and stopped. He proposed to spend the remaining few minutes putting questions to the boys. He ordered the whole class to put away their books and asked someone in the second row, what is the date of Vasco da Gama's arrival in India? So a little was left. So he decided to just spend rest of the time in asking questions instead of completing the chapter. So he told everyone to close the books and started asking questions. He asked someone, what is the date of Vasco da Gama's arrival in India? Swaminathan sat up and screamed. 1648.
Ma'am is called, Mathil looked angrily.
At the top of his voice. Swaminathan said, 1648, December 20. You didn't shout, said the teacher. He asked, has your headache made you mad? Still, he was keeping his patience. The teacher was keeping his patience and asked, that has your headache made you mad? You are still shouting. I have no headache now, sir, replied the thundered brightly. Once again, he shouted and told that he didn't have any headache. Sit down, you idiot. Swami was thrilled at being called an idiot. Will anyone feel happy at being called an idiot? But he felt happy.
No, ma'am.
Why did he feel happy?
Because
he was successful in irritating the teacher. If anyone is irritated, then he or she calls someone an idiot, not in a happy mood. So Swami was very happy at the what did he say? Sit down, you idiot. Swami felt happy. If you get up again, I will cane you, said the teacher. Swami sat down, feeling happy at the promise. Now Swami is very happy. Next, who was supposed
to? Ma'am, can I Anushansa?
Anushansa, start. Anushansa.
The teacher then asked, I am going to put a few questions on the Mughal period. Among the Mughal emperors, whom would you call the greatest, whom the strongest, and whom the most religious emperor? Swami got up. As soon as he was seen, the teacher was emphatically, sit down. I want to answer, sir. Sit down. No, sir. I want to answer. What did I say? I could do if you got up again. You said you would cane me and peel the skin off my knuckles and make me press it on my forehead. All right, come here. Swaminathan left his seat joyfully and hopped on the platform. The teacher took out his cane from the drawer and shouted angrily, open your hand, you little devil. He whacked three wholesome cuts on each palm. Swami received them without blenching, showing signs of fear. After half a dozen, the teacher asked, will this do or do you want some more? Swami merrily held out his hand again and received two more, and the bell rang. Swami jumped down from the platform with a light heart. Though his hands were smarting, he picked up his books, took out the letter lying in his pocket, and ran to the headmaster's room. He found the door locked. He asked the peon, where is the headmaster? Why do you want him? My father has sent a letter for him. He has taken the afternoon off and won't come back for a week. You can give the letter to the assistant headmaster. He will be here now. Who is he? Your teacher, Samuel. He will be here in a second. Swaminathan fled from the place. As soon as Swami went home with the letter, father remarked, I knew would not deliver it, you coward. I swear our headmaster is on leave. Swaminathan began. Father replied, don't lie in addition to being a coward. Swami held up the envelope and said, I will give this to the headmaster as soon as he is back. Father snatched it from his hand, tore it up, and thrust it into the waste paper basket under his table. He muttered, don't come to me for help, even if Samuel throttles you. You deserve your Samuel.
Good. So, what happened?
Ma'am, what is the meaning of coward?
Okay, I will first let me start from here. Then I will reach there. I will explain. The teacher then asked, I am going to put a few questions on the Mughal period. Among Mughal emperors, whom would you call the greatest, whom the strongest, and whom the most religious? Earlier question was being asked from Vasco da Gama's arrival in India. Now once again, Swami got up. As soon as he had seen, the teacher said emphatically, sit down. Because teacher has already said that, ordered Swami not to get up, not to shout. Once again, Swami got up. So teacher simply said, but in a loud voice, sit down. I want to answer, sir. Sit down. No, sir. I want to answer. Now he was insisting. What did I see? What did I say? I would do if you got up again. Now Samuel was trying to make him remember that what did he say? What did he say? Actually, Samuel said that he would beat him. But what did Swami answer? He said that, you said you would cane me and peel the skin off my knuckles and make me press it on my forehead. Has he told these lines?
No, ma'am.
What did he say?
I will cane you.
I will cane you. But he added all these lines to provoke him. All right, come here. Now, Samuel lost his temperament and called him. Swaminathan felt left his seat joyfully and hopped on the platform. The teacher took out his cane from the drawer and shouted angrily, open your hand, you little devil. He wagged 3 wholesome cuts on each palm. He wagged means cane जो होता है ना कोड़े मारना का इंग्लिश होता है wagged. So how many canes he had given? 3 on? No, 3 wholesome cuts on each palm. दोनों palm हाथ में तो 2 palm होते हैं ना तो 3 into 2 6. Swami received
yes, ma'am.
Swami received them without blenching. What is the meaning of blenching?
Showing signs of fear.
So he was not fearful. Why was he not fearful?
Showing signs of fear.
Okay. After half a dozen, the teacher asked, will these do or do you want some more? After giving 6 cuts, he asked, is it okay? 6 cuts enough hai aur tumko aur chahiye? Swami merely held out his hand again, received 2 more. Phir se haath badha diya aur 2 aur. Means he got, total he got 8 and the bell rang. A bell bhi, now the last period was over. Swami jumped down from the platform with a light heart. Though his hands were smarting. Light hurt because he must be feeling the pain. Chot lagi thi to dard to hui raha hoga na. He must be feeling pain. Lekin uske hands were smarting. Why the hands were smarting? Because those hands were having proof to justify his father's letter. He picked up his books, took out the letter, lying in his pocket and ran to the headmaster's room. He found the room locked. Now he got solid proof. But what happened? When he reached the headmaster's room, the door was locked. He asked the PM, "Where is the headmaster? Why do you want him?" PM asked, "Kyun milna chahte ho headmaster se?" "My father has sent a letter for him. He has taken the afternoon off and won't come back for a week. You can give the letter to the assistant headmaster. He will be here now." He said that, the PN said that, "Headmaster will not come for a week, but you can deliver your letter to the assistant headmaster." Swami asked, "Who is he?" "Your teacher, Samuel. He will be here in seconds." Swaminathan fled from the place. As soon as Swami went home with the letter, our father remarked, "I know you would not deliver the letter, you coward." So what happened? How could he deliver the letter to the Samuel? So deliver the letter to Samuel. So what happened? He took here. He just